Hello, this is going to be another lesson for Edit the Sad Parts by Modest Mouse. I'm pretty sure this was the first song I ever did. It was either this or Positive Negative, but a couple people have asked me to clarify some things on this, so I'm just going to redo it. So the two chords you need to know for the intro are E minor. So it's open E, second fret of the A, second fret of the D, and then you also grab this third fret of the B. So from that to a D major, which you just leave your ring finger on the third fret here. So yeah, E minor, D major. So I'm gonna play along to it and then I will teach the other parts as we get there. So here we go. So that part after the intro, you again just leave your ring finger there and slide it up to the 10th fret of the B. And then it's this is like a G chord, so it's middle finger on the 10th fret of the A, first finger on the 9th fret of the D. And someone asked me how you mute this G string, but you don't. You just let it ring open. Yeah, you just let it ring open, but I guess if you wanted to mute it, I don't know, you could kind of do it with the pad of your first finger here. But I just let it ring open, so it's that chord. And then grab the 12th fret of the B. So. And then down to the 8th fret. So. And so that was down to the 8th fret of the B and then sliding back up to the 10th fret. So. And then when you do that, you go from 10th fret of the A, 10th fret or 9th fret of the D. You just move these two fingers over to the E and A. And then just strum all the open strings. But on this one, you are muting the D string with just when I grab it this way, when I grab this 9th fret of the A string here, it's muting the D. So but if you don't want to do that, so that's the little melody part that's going is. So it's. This part's kind of weird, but yeah, if you can't get that part, you can just do. Because that's what he starts doing, so it's. So to do that, I strum and then kind of just lift up a little bit. You don't take your fingers completely off like this. You just left off so they're not fretting the note. And then it goes to this part. And all that is the same thing you had. You had 10th fret of the A, 9th fret of the D. And you're letting the open G string ring. And then grabbing the 11th fret up to the 12th fret, so. And then same thing, move your fingers over to the E and A strings and do the same thing, 11th and then 12th fret on the D. And the back. And I'm doing all downstrokes there, but you can do alternate strums too, like. And then it just goes back into this. And then there's this little solo here, or not really solo, but a little fill thing here. And it's just 10th fret of the high E to 10th fret of the B. And then, so you need to grab, yeah, so it's. So all that is just the high E and B strings. It's 10th fret, and then 10th fret down to the 9th fret. So that was 10-9 on the E, and then 10th fret of the B. And then he starts doing pull-offs. So we want to grab the 10th fret of the B with your middle finger, 9th fret with your first finger, or however it's comfortable for you. You can do it like this, actually. But just do however it's comfortable is the main thing. And so then what you're doing is you're fretting the 9th fret of the E and the 10th fret, and then you strum and let go, and you pull off with the 10th fret to the 9th, like that. So. And then it's all on the B string here. 10, 12. So that was 10, 12, 8. So. And then down to the 7th fret of the G. So again, that was 10th, 12th, and 8th fret, all of the B string. 7th fret of the G. And then back to the same thing, the 8th, 10th, and 12th of the B. So that was 10th fret of the B down to the 3rd. And then it just goes back into the intro chords. And then at the very end, he starts doing this. Yeah, so that was all on the 7th and 9th fret of the D string. Fuck. I don't know. Sorry. But yeah, mess with that. It's...